Hi, Minnie here from AppsFlyer. If you're like most app marketers right now, you probably feel like you just wrapped your head around SKAdNetwork 2 and 3, and now you have to figure out SKAN 4.0? Well, we've got you covered. To help you make sense of it all, we'll be answering your 7 burning questions on SKAN 4.0 and give you actionable insights on how to optimize your app marketing performance in the early days of adoption. So let's dive into question 1. How do you design a coarse value schema? A coarse value has only 3 values for each window: low, medium, and high. In this example, we're looking at how an advertiser configures their schema based on revenue for shopping. In window 1, we use low for add to cart. This example is based on the most measurable metrics and events among our SKAN customers in each vertical. Although our example shows the same configuration for all windows, you can use a different set of conversion value mappings for each. This is a similar example of how advertisers can configure their schema based on revenue for casual games. In this example, we're looking at in-app events to grade engagement from opening the app to payment. To see which events correlate with LTV in each window, you'll want to rerun data analyses. Moving to question 2. Should you use LockWindow? Yes, we recommend that you use LockWindow for data freshness. It can take up to 13 days for the second post back to be delivered, so why not get it sooner if you can? So how should you deploy LockWindow? There are 2 options. I'll start with the first one. Lock the window after a predetermined period of time has passed. The benefit of LockWindow is that it allows you to freeze measurement and lock in the conversion value to receive postbacks sooner. But the problem with LockWindow is that for it to work, the user has to have already launched the app. So let's say you decide to lock the measurement window on day 5, and the user launches the app on day 6. The lock mechanism would only be triggered from that point. The second option is to lock when the coarse value is high, like when a user makes a purchase. This ensures you don't waste time waiting for the window to close while avoiding a user needing to open the app to trigger the locking mechanism in the first place. So what do you do in the transition period? We recommend not waiting to adopt SKAN 4.0. But in order for it to work, the ad network must generate the ad signature for version 4.0, and the advertised app has to run on a device with iOS version 16.1 or newer. Moving on to question 5. What should you ask your media partners, and what kind of answers will you get? This is a very important question, as media partners play a vital role in SKAN 4.0 and are relatively slow to adopt. You can start by asking about value layers. Ask them, are you able to optimize for the second and third postback window, or just for the first? Since networks usually prefer early signals for rapid optimization, you can expect they'll say first postback and then second and third postback for cohort assessment. Follow up with the question, how will you deal with coarse and fine-grained values? And they will likely tell you, for coarse, we'll input basic values like subscribers, app open, trial started, and converted to paid. And for fine, we'll add detailed layers to assess the value of a coarse trial. Lastly, ask about campaign IDs, also known as source identifiers. Ask them, what are your best practices for a new schema on your network? Since it's hard to know, they'll probably tell you to test, test, test. And finally, ask them, what can you map in 3 to 4 digits, and what will it show you? They may say your ability to segment by geo and creative is the most important. All right, question 6. How can revenue modeling help you be more efficient? Once again, we have 2 options. Option 1, you're not using day 7 modeling and you're looking at revenue. Then you'll need to dedicate the first and second postback coarse values to measure revenue. Then you can receive day 7 revenue up to 13 days post-install. In option 2, you're using day 7 modeling and a single source of truth solution to eliminate duplications from SKAN and MMP revenue, so that you can get revenue metrics after 7 days instead of up to 13. You'll be able to measure revenue with the fine-grained conversion value while using coarse values to measure events and retention. If you decide to measure revenue in the second window, you can still enrich your performance reports with the additional data from SKAN. We recommend going with this option, as you won't need to use coarse-grained values to measure revenue. The last and most important question is, can you do it yourself? In short, it's probably best not to. Although doing it on your own was possible for SKAN 2 and 3, Doing it alone in SKAN 4.0 is 10 times harder. So we recommend working with a mobile measurement partner to help build your conversion value schemas, migrate to the new version without losing any data, and help you overcome the limitations that still exist today. And that just about covers the basics of SKAN 4.0. I hope we answered your 7 burning questions, and if you have any others, let us know in the comments below. As always, if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all things mobile marketing. That's it for now, and we'll see you next time.